rejoice and be glad in it. Hallelujah, hallelujah. To God be the glory for all the good things he's done in our lives. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Love you.
Because they're definitely a good phrase with Chinatown, Kingdom Town. Look at Genesis. Read that whole slide for us. And the fact is that we're, hey, Brother Jackson, we was created in that image.
Amen.
The kingdom image, the God image. Hey, go ahead, Elder.
And God said, let us make man in our image.
Come on now.
After our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea.
Come on.
And over the fowl of the air, and over the cattle.
Come on.
Over all the earth, and over every creeping thing that creeps upon the earth.
Yes, sir.
So God created man in his own image.
Yes, sir.
In the image of God created he him, male and female created he them.
Yes, sir.
And God blessed them, and God said unto them, be fruitful and multiply, and replenish the earth, and subdue it, and have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over every living thing that moveth upon the earth.
Go ahead, sir.
1 Corinthians 15:49, and as we have borne the image of the earthly, we shall also bear the image of the heavenly.
Yes, sir.
Romans 8:29. For whom he did foreknow, he also did predestine.
Yes, sir.
To be conformed to the master's will, right? Paul just say it. Let me chew on that for a minute myself. For whom he did foreknow, he also did predestine to be conformed to the image of his son.
Come on, sir.
He might be the firstborn among many brethren.
Come on, hey, Chinatown, Kingdom Town. We're supposed to have the image. We're supposed to allow that image. We're supposed to be transformed to that image. And we allow, look, it's not you making the image. He's making the image. We were made, matter of fact, look, in fact, in reality, you love said it back and said back in Genesis from the beginning.
Yeah.
We're supposed to be in the image, in the likeness. Chinatown is in the image, in the likeness of China, huh? We're talking about us though, we're in the image, in the likeness of God.
Mm-hmm.
And therefore we just walk, that's who we are. That's not some law, not legalism. Forget legalism, I don't care about legalism. It doesn't matter. This is who you are.
There was something there. The term kingdom keeps has been plaguing me for the last couple of weeks. So
yes, sir.
And a kingdom is a place where a king reigns.
Come on now.
And they said that the kingdom of God comes not by observation, but is revealed from within.
Yes, sir.
And so when we look at Jesus Christ, we saw a being who was a man who was totally submitted to the will of God.
Yes, sir.
Completely sold out to God's will, to the Father's will. And the evidence of him, of God's kingdomship or his lordship, was the fact that Jesus did those things that the Father required of him. He said, I always do those things that please the Father.
Come on.
And so when I was thinking, about this kingdom thing, when it says it's not revealed, it does not come by observation, but it's revealed from within.
Right.
The kingdom for me, in seeking the kingdom, which is something, to seek ye first the kingdom of God and all the righteousness and all these things be added unto you, is to seek the rulership of God in my life.
In your life.
If that makes sense.
Yes, sir.
It's like my task or my effort in this dispensation of this age or whatever it is to seek God's leadership, his rulership in my life, in all things. Seeking guidance from him. So I was looking at what we talked about when we go into Chinatown, we see the manifestations of the Chinese culture for the most part, right?
Yes, sir.
That culture is a list of rules, regulations, of dress, of religion, of diet, you know, the things that they eat, manifested there, the way that they address one another, the way they interact with one another. These are all some kind of prompts that they have in accordance with that culture.
Yes, sir.
That culture dictates to them certain things, and they behave in accordance with those dictates. Same thing with the kingdom of God. The kingdom of God, I think, people, when they see people of the kingdom, they should see us, what's the word, submitted to the lordship of Jesus Christ.
Uh-huh.
They should see a body of people who are submitted to his leadership, to his rulership. So they have certain things to say: love your enemies, bless them that curse you, pray for them that despitefully use you, persecute you.
Right.
Those kind of things have been established to us for no. And when they encounter us, that is what they should experience.
Yes, sir.
As we're being conformed to the image of the Son, because the bottom line was that he was submitted to his Father. He submitted to his Father's leadership. He submitted to his Father's rulership. And that was the guiding, how do you say, what's the word I'm looking for?
Principles.
That was a guiding prescription of guiding.
Principles, right?
Yes, the guiding principles was his submission to his Father. That's what literally caused him to be the person he was, to do the things that he did, and to appear in the manner that he appeared. So that got a little bit more clearer to me when I thought about the fact that Jesus, the Lord, should be ruling my life.
Rulership. And I like to throw some things at you too about, so when I talk about when I enter Chinatown, I see these different, even some of the structures and the clothing and all that other stuff. Mm-hmm. I think people should see that you've been transformed. First of all, there's a transformation that's happening, and it's an ongoing transformation, Brother Jackson. It's not something that happens all at one time. So one thing they can see is the transformation of a person moving from self to him.
Listen, this
right.